After a very exciting first race and a great win for Jochen Hahn, the conditions took a big turn for the worse. A lot of rain between the races meant that we had to do a lap behind the pace truck, and then we were going to have two yellow flag laps as well for drivers to make sure that they had everything nice and safe, and of course for the race director to ensure that we could have a full green flag race and we didn't have to call them in on grounds of safety. Stefan Fass would still lead them all the way after getting the reverse grid pole position. Everybody tiptoed their way round, and as you could see, visibility was at a premium. By the time the drivers had completed two laps, it seemed like the spray was just something they'd have to deal with. There was plenty of it, but the drivers managed to still keep their heads down and get around safely. Everyone was itching to get going, staying nice and close together. And eventually, when the green flag flew, plenty of wheel spin and plenty of overtaking. Jochen Hahn here overtaking Antonio Albacete, who finished second in the first race. And Stefan Fass managed to hold on to the lead for just a little bit. That's not without tries from Jamie Anderson, involving a little bit of contact. After a slide from Jamie, though, Adam Latchko would take advantage and go through very easily in a straight line on the right-hand side. Before long, he'd try to line up an attack on Stefan Fass, now that there was a little bit of daylight between them. But Stefan made a mistake and lost the lead at the very next corner. Latchko suddenly going from third to first. Anderson would also go past Fass as well, and everybody piled in, including Lenz and Kish, to try and get a bit of the action. Norbert Kish eventually would get past the tactical 24 machine, but that's not without this very hairy moment going up towards the chicane. Not long after that, Jochen Hahn was the next truck to try and have a go at the number 24. Stefan Fass having a bit of a tough time, but he would eventually go on to finish in sixth place. Sascha Lenz was now attacking Adam Latchko for the lead, but he had to worry about the hungry Hungarian behind him, Norbert Kish. And inevitably, it was not long before Norbert's MAN was back in front and on the hunt, chasing down Latchko. Luke Garrett was in a good scrap between Andre Kurzym and Steffi Halm. But what we needed to watch was right at the very front. Lap after lap, Norbert Kish tried it around the outside, making the most of the wet weather, even with a bit of contact into the final couple of corners as well. But still, Latchko managed to hold on. That was until the very final lap of the race. Kish managed to hold it around the outside at the long left-hander. And through the next double right apex, he was able to get the job done. Here a view from on board with Sascha Lenz. And another win going the way of Norbert Kish. Adam Latchko would finish second, with Sascha Lenz in third place. And Kish celebrated as Kish celebrates. Fantastic drifting display from him once again in that number 41 Revace Racing MAN. Kish celebrates on the podium, and we caught up with him and Adam Latchko after the race.
I think it's a nice battle. Today we have big trouble with the setup, and we try something and it's still not working on the wet condition, and we will see tomorrow. But I think it's a nice race for spectators and for us, I think, also.
How high is the adrenaline? Congratulations to this win.
Thank you. Yeah, it was great. Well, for sure today it was working for us better. And I'm still shaking a little bit because it was really exciting, because I could see that I can go faster and I could attack, but it's always difficult to overtake in the rain, and especially somebody like Adam, who is very good in the rain.
So another fantastic win going the way of Norbert Kish, one that he certainly had to work for, especially against somebody that's as good in the rain, like he said, as Adam Latchko. Sascha Lenz was third ahead of Jochen Hahn and Jamie Anderson, with Stefan Fass sixth. Shane Brereton was seventh ahead of Antonio Albacete. Andre Kurzym and Luke Garrett. Jamie Anderson's fifth place meant that he won the Goodyear Cup, with Steffi Halm 11th, Renny Reiner, Louis Requenco and Heinrich Clemens Hecker rounding out the field. But we'll be back with more action of the same tomorrow for races 3 and 4. We'll catch you then.